Applying UDL with Professor Tom Tobin.
Hello friends, I'm Tom Tobin, and I'm here to help you start applying Universal Design for Learning, or UDL. As you've learned in this UDL in Tertiary Education series, Universal Design for Learning can entail a lot of work, especially when we look at entire courses or programs of study in vocational and higher education. So where should you get started? Set aside the official definition of UDL, you know, multiple means of engagement, representation, action, and expression, and start with a step zero, plus one thinking. Think about the interactions that your learners have right now, with materials, with each other, with an instructor or support person, with a wider community. Now, think about how many ways your learners can successfully accomplish those interactions. If there's one path to success right now, add one more path. Share a printed outline alongside your live lecture. Allow students to submit written or audio recorded responses to an activity. To keep your effort manageable, apply the plus one approach first to interactions that already aren't going how you planned them. Call these your pinch points. Say your learners all get confused about a key concept every time you teach it, so much so that you end up having to reteach it. Or they all send you the same question by email 650 times. Or they all get low marks on a test. Those are the places to start with a little plus one thinking. Thank you for being part of this UDL in Tertiary Education series. As you complete this e-learning program and apply UDL principles in your interactions with learners, remember that you can start small and build up access a piece at a time, testing as you go. So thank you for trying the plus one approach with just one of your learning interactions, and here's to success in lowering barriers to learning for everyone. Cheers.
This video was produced for the Universal Design for Learning in Tertiary Education e-learning resource. For more information, visit www.disabilityawareness.com.au.